Our focus is on cutting-edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
Big Tech.
Points, the first of one of which is relatively straightforward. When we're talking of CSR activities, one of CSR activities don't make much sense. Investment, and by investment I mean much more than money, it is effort, it is the thinking over a period of time in a particular area is what will make the difference. Second, clearly CSR will not, well, it's still part of the first actually, it's not the second part. Clearly CSR will not be a addition to government resources for various programs. It is, I believe, to help, and that's my second point, to help create new ideas, new business models, new ways of delivering services. So, the last session that you had, which was focusing on road safety, the fact is, if people come together and you can provide alternative methods, that becomes a way in which there is a meaningful impact. Similarly, in the environment area, what we have seen is that there is a huge issue as far as environmental pollution is concerned, and at this moment, given the relationship with the automotive sector, let me focus particularly on air pollution. I will very, very briefly touch on one more area, which is the end of life of vehicles and their impact on the environment. But you know, today, there is a huge amount of air pollution. Even today, the outside air quality, I think, is something of the order of 450 micrograms cubic meter as far as PM2.5 is concerned. Now, through a variety of regulations, the emissions from automobiles are limited. I think even in winters, at the most, they're 20% of the total. But 20% still takes us above the 60 micrograms a cubic meter limit for PM2.5 that the world would like us to have. But what it means is there's a lot of work in other areas as well. The automobile sector, once regulations are clear, will obviously implement them and has implemented them and will meet them. By themselves, they are not enough. So that's the second point. I think supporting a set of initiatives which contributes to air pollution, even when it is not coming from automobiles, is a way of making your impact on the quality of air. And I do believe that apart from the issue of being concerned citizens, there is also the added advantage of being able to pilot new kinds of activities which address air pollution. What those are, I will come in a moment. But let me touch the second area. I believe that we are already starting to see a major issue arising from the disposal of at the end of life issues associated with vehicles. You could very well say, this is not my cup of tea, I have sold the car, that's it. Yes, individual companies, yes. But as a sector, I believe that this is an issue that is going to become more and more relevant, particularly as landfills, as the space available for landfills becomes more and more scarce. Consequently, what are the kinds of ways in which these wastes can be turned into useful products for somebody else? That's an area where I think there's very little thinking that has been done, and I believe that there is a need to start thinking. The third issue is, I believe that if the industry acts as a whole, it has got a lot greater impact than individual companies. Now, there is this particular area, it is branded with one particular company. But it would be useful if you call it SIAM or the automobile industry as a whole, because if you've got it coordinated, activities with several manufacturers are supporting, the overall impact will be more and the ability for transformation will be more. Short point, My suggestion is focus on air pollution, focus on the end of life of vehicles, and try to see if the entire industry as a whole can have a coordinated program with individual companies taking responsibilities for different parts. Thanks, Naveen.